Just with your phones, you can make some joyful noise. Oh, make some joyful noise. This is beautiful. Make some joyful noise. Brother Foster and our sister Ruth. Praise the Lord.
Dearly beloved, we are met here together in the presence of God and in the sight of one another to join together Foster and Ruth in holy matrimony. This is an honorable estate and of divine origin and institution. It is sanctioned and approved of in the Holy Scriptures and dignified and forever hallowed by the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ in Cana, in Galilee, where he performed his first miracle. He speaks to us of the mystical union of Christ and his church. St. Paul, speaking of it, says marriage is honorable among all men. And so we must conclude that it must not be regarded in a light manner, but undertaken and entered into in all solemnity with wisdom and forethought, reverently and in the fear of God, with understanding that it was first ordained for the mutual help, society, and comfort that one ought to have of the other in prosperity and in adversity. Into this holy bond, Foster and Ruth, here present, are now ready to enter. Therefore, if any man can show any just cause why they may not lawfully be joined together, let him or her now speak, or hereafter forever hold your peace. So if anyone has any just cause, only a just cause. Hallelujah. All right. Since there's no objection and no one has any just cause, even if you had it, I would strike it down. So Foster, will you have Ruth to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's holy ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep you only unto her as long as you both shall live? If you do, say, yes, I will, may the Lord help me.
Yes, I will, may the Lord help me.
Amen. Hallelujah. Ruth, will you have this man, Foster, be your wedded husband, to live together after God's holy ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love, honor, and obey him in sickness and in health, and in forsaking all others, keep only unto him as long as you both shall live? If you do, yes, say, I do, may the Lord help me.
I do, may the Lord help me.
Amen. Who gives this woman to be married to this nice gentleman?
Yes, I do.
Isn't you alone? Or... Okay, so you
and also for mommy. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's give them a hand.
It's always the greatest honor to give your daughter into marriage, especially if he's a good man like Foster. Hallelujah.
Amen.
All right, please turn and face each other at this time.
All right. So, Foster, I want you to say this after me as you look into the eyes, eyeball to eyeball, of Ruth. I call upon all of you, present to witness,
present to witness,
that I do take you, Ruth,
I do take you, Ruth,
to be my lawful wedded wife,
be my lawful wedded wife,
to have and to hold,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward,
from this day forward,
for better, for worse,
for better, for worse,
for richer, for poorer,
for richer, for poorer,
in sickness and in health,
in sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish,
to love and cherish,
till death do us part,
till death do us part,
according to God's holy ordinance,
according to God's holy ordinance,
and
thereto I pledge thee
my troth,
my troth.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. All right. So, Ruth, please look into Foster's eyes and say this after me. I call upon all present here.
I call upon all present here
to witness.
To witness
that I.
That I. Ruth Esinyakwa.
Do take thee.
Do take thee, Foster Kojo Chuma Sampo.
To be my lawfully wedded wife, husband.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy
and
ordinance. And thereto. I give thee.
My troth.
My troth.
Praise the Lord. Brothers and sisters, there are two beautiful rings before me. And there are two things I want to share about them. First, they are made up of precious metals, which means that as the years come and go, it becomes better. I've worn this ring for 32 years, and it's still sharp. And so as the years, maybe you would do like 50, 55, 60, but it will still be good. And that is how your love for each other is going to be. It's going to be better and better and better with the years. Hallelujah. And God will make it happen. Also, it is round. I don't see any beginning. I don't see any end. It goes round and round and round. It means that your love should continue and continue and continue without an end. It will be forever. Even when we get to heaven, you will check. You won't be married there, but you will check him out. And say, that's my husband. Hallelujah. And so let me pray, and we will put these rings on. Foster and Ruth will put it on each other. Let's pray together. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for the gift of love. Lord, we learn love from the amazing love you showed us through Jesus Christ. When he laid down his life on the cross of Calvary for us. And Lord, this morning we are gathered here and we are holding this token of the love that Foster and Ruth have for each other. Lord, we are praying that because their love for each other is so precious, it will be renewed every day of their lives. It will never be tainted nor destroyed, but it will be better and better and better as the years go by. And Lord, not only will it be better, but it will continue forever. That they will feed their love for each other. That they will sustain their love for each other. And it will grow from strength to strength, from grace to grace, and from glory to glory. In the name of Jesus. It will be a love that will never cease. Because it's a love that is implanted in their heart by the Spirit of the living God. We thank you. We sanctify these rings in the blood of Jesus. We pray that as they put it on, it will only bring blessing. Any evil eye that will look at these rings, we blindfold it in the name of Jesus. And we pray, oh God, that it will be a blessing to them and you will be glorified. Not only will this ring beautify their fingers and their hands, but it will beautify their love for you and for one another. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Amen. And say this after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As the token and memorial.
As a token and memorial.
That I have taken you.
That I have taken you. Ruth,
to be my lawfully wedded wife.
My lawful wedded wife.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord. It's looking good, Ruth. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As the token.
As the token.
And memorial.
And memorial.
That I have taken you.
That I have taken you, Foster Kwejo Chum Asampong.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. That a man shall leave his mother and father, and the two shall become one flesh. What God has joined together, let no man put asunder. For as much as Foster Sampong and Ruth Nyakua have consented together in holy wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and there too have given and pledged their troth to one another, and have declared the same by the giving and receiving of a ring, and by the joining of hands, I pronounce them to be man and wife together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. What God has put together, let no man, no woman, no demon, no witch, no power, no principality, put it asunder, because they cannot. This marriage is sealed by the power of the Most High. Amen. Let me read a few scriptures. Ruth, Bible says in Ephesians 5:22-28, wives, submit yourself to your own husband, your own, as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Foster, the Bible says, husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, that he might present it to himself, a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. Foster, today, Pastor Nyako has presented her daughter to you for you to marry. Now, the next stage is for you to take care of her and present her to yourself. And so you do so by giving yourself to her as Christ gave himself to the church to sanctify her, to cleanse her by the washing of water by the word, and present her to yourself every day as a glorious woman and wife and companion, not having spot or wrinkle. If the wrinkles start, please make sure you smoothen it out. Or any satin, that she'll be holy and without blemish.
May you enjoy a fruitful marriage, a happy marriage, a long marriage, a blessed marriage. May you, Foster and Ruth, be an example unto many. This I declare in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let's put our hands together for Jesus, who has answered this prayer and every prayer that I have made.
Hallelujah. Amen. Please rise again. Today is a great day. And God has performed another miracle. One and one put together has become one. And therefore, I declare, by the authority conferred on me, not just by the government, but also by the powers of heaven, that Foster and Ruth are married forever.
Amen. 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 All right.
So, let her hand go for a little. All right. Now, you have to salute your bride. But before you do that, I want you to go to Pastor and Mrs. Nyako and thank them. Let's go and thank them for all right. Of course, an Auntie Effie. Praise the Lord. All right. So I want you to check her out and also give her
the best case ever.
The best is always in the house of God. Therefore, take her, hold her, and give her the best kiss ever. They said they didn't catch it. One more time. Yeah. Uh-huh. You did all right. Great. All right. Okay, so I want to introduce to you for the first time ever Foster and Ruth, a sample. Mr. and Mrs. Foster and Ruth, a sample. Put your hands together for them.
May the Lord touch you. May the Lord meet you at the point of your need. May every marriage that is struggling be revived. May everything that you are waiting for, because you are here, even as you have become a blessing to Ruth and Foster, may the Lord bless you.
Amen.
May the Lord protect all of you.
Amen.
And keep you safe and secure in His perfect love and care. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah.
To the Lord this afternoon for what he has done in our midst. It is time to cut the cake. Mrs. as if we should have done it, but on behalf of the whole team, we cut the cake in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. We are praying that the favor of God rest upon you as we cut this cake. May the good Lord favor you, bless you, lead you in everything that you do, so that at the end of everything, each and every one will have cause to praise the Lord and glorify him in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Oh, give them a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, come on, clap for them, clap for them.
Now it's time for Ruth to feed. That's Mr. Foster, amen.
I'm a pastor's daughter, and he's a pastor's son, a pastor's daughter. Isn't it wonderful? Amen. Amen. On behalf of the church, the Apostolic Church, our Grace Assembly, I'm here to present the certificate to Mr. and Mrs. Asampo. But I will hand it over to the woman because we are very capable of keeping things. I'm not going to give it to you because next year, by this time, when I ask you, you might not be find it. So I'm going to give it to Mrs. Ruth Asampo. Amen. Amen.
He hardly does it, but today we are all going to see. You see the walkers, it's different. DJ, let's go.
Yeah. keep it short so that you can enjoy your meal and dance. But we just wanted to take a few moments just to say a few words for the people that we're here for today, Ruth and Foster. Ruth is our older sister, so we've known her our whole life. And you know, before I continue, can we just give her a round of applause? Isn't she beautiful? There are many words that I can use to describe Ruth. She's very generous, she's very selfless. Of course, she's brilliant, she's gorgeous. But as the oldest sister, she's always been the first to do a number of things. She was the first to graduate from high school, graduate from college. She's the first to get married, and she'll be the first to be called doctor. And today, Ruth, as we're here just celebrating you, we just want to take a moment just to wish you all the best in the journey that you're about to go on. We know that you are a great person, and therefore you are going to be a great wife, because, I mean, come on, let's be honest. We just want to wish you all the blessings that married life has to offer. We just want to pray that every day, every week, every month, and every year of married life is better than the previous. We pray that you never lack anything at all, and even the things that you weren't able to do on your own, now that you are with Foster, you'll be able to excel in all areas. We love you so, 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 so much. It's been a long journey to get here. I'm not gonna cry, but you know how much we love you, and we're so grateful that you've been able to find someone who compliments you and adds to you, and to be able to give us a big brother that we never had. So we're gonna hand it over so that other people can say a few things, but Ruth, we're just so happy for you and happy that we can celebrate today with you.
Yes, Tina said it all. Ruth knows my big sister, our second mom. I never cry, but for today, Ruth, I'm gonna miss you. My roommate. And now, Foster, you're taking her to be your roommate. I'm gonna visit, so you guys better make a room for me. But we love you guys so much. I'm so happy today because we already have a brother. We have some big brothers, but now we have a true brother-in-law who we already call him as a brother. So this isn't anything new. We love you both. Thank you.
All right, all right, all right. You done? You done? All right, so, you know, I'm Dante Kufo, and this is Belwin. You know, we've been friends with you for years, so we're both going to, you know, say our piece. But, yeah, so I met Foster for the first time in 2001, and, you know, it's been a trip. You know, since then, Foster has always been there for me through all types of things. To me, he's the one-stop shop, you know, full-time comedian, musician, confident, hustler. And last but not least, he was the older brother I never had. So, you know, we would have conversations about everything from sports, school, social media, and others. Yo, and I would call him at all times of the hours. Like, yo, like 3 a.m., 4, like, yo, we up for hours, bro. And, you know, since we're musicians, you know, we used to stay up, you know, trying to learn things. You know, Belwin knows, bro. Then it was never ending. But, you know, one topic that we always talked about was, I mean, you know how guys are. Talked about women, of course. But one person in particular was always popping up. And it was confusing to me, because I'm like, why are you talking about this person? And I was like, all right, you know what? There's probably something here. And then come to find out, that's when I knew, you know, they were getting together. I was like, okay, this is great, you know. But on that note, bro, congrats to you. Congrats to you and Ruth, and, you know, we love you, bro. So just as Pastor said, the two are always better than one. So congrats, bro.
All right. Foster, you know, it's funny how we met. I met Foster through Dante, and we met around 2010. And it was through music. You know, I remember back then there was no thing as group time, FaceTime, right? So we used to be on the phone for like several hours on Uvu. For like, that's the Uvu days, like, you know, till like 4 a.m., 5 a.m., and then everyone is gonna knock out. But I'm not going to talk much. You know I love you, bro. Ruth, I love you. Congratulations. And I'm going to miss the night FaceTime calls.
So we're just going to ask you all just to hold your glass and just join us even as we toast. We're going to go up just to toast to more prosperity. We're going to go down to toast to more love. And we're going to toast to more babies. So go ahead and cheers. Congratulations, Ruth and Foster. We love you. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers.
Yeah. is a movie, and you're the best part. Oh, 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 you're the best part. Oh, 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 best part. If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? Won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? Love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? Love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something?